and welcome. You're logged on to Indian Times, daily.com, the only portal for global Indians. We broadcast news from India, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat in English, Punjabi and Gujarati languages. And our portal and apps have a list of well-established businesses and resources that every global Indian needs. I'm Anuja Kashyap and today's headlines are... In India, a veteran journalist has been shot dead by militants in Kashmir and PM Modi has said that Digital India is a fight against torts. In Punjab, Chandigarh Airport has remained shut for the second consecutive day and the murderer of a Pakistani Sikh leader has been arrested. In Canada, there has been a 200% rise in Indian invitees for residency and conservatives are set to force an all-night voting on carbon pricing. Stay tuned to Indian Times, daily.com and I'll be back with all the news that is important for you from India, Canada and Punjab.
Get the mortgage that's best for you from Abdul Kaiser, Principal Broker of Ingenious Mortgages. We offer first and second mortgages and refinancing. We deal with multiple lenders. We also conduct the REMIC course and exam to become a mortgage agent in just 1 week at our location. Call us at 416-887-9196 or log on to www.ingeniousmortgages.ca.
Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are: Veteran journalist Sujit Bukhari has been shot dead by militants in Kashmir while he was boarding his car. This has drawn wide condemnation from politicians across India. Several journalist bodies condemned the killing and demanded swift action against the forces responsible for his killing. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has said that his pet Digital India initiative is a war against touts and middlemen. He stated that it helped check black money and black marketing while creating immense job opportunities in small towns and rural areas. Opposition leader Tejasvi Yadav has demanded president's rule in Bihar and said that Chief Minister Nitish Kumar was unable to administer the state. A day earlier, a 45-year-old woman and her 14-year-old daughter were allegedly gang-raped by nearly a dozen youths in Gaya district. The Aam Aadmi Party has apprehended moves to break the four-day-old sit-in strike by Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal, with the centre deploying more police force near the Lieutenant Governor's house. They have been demanding a direction to the IAS officers working in the Delhi administration to end their undeclared strike. Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal has written a fresh letter to PM Narendra Modi seeking his intervention to end the IAS officers' strike. He also hit out at his detractors, saying that the sit-in was not for personal gains but for greater good of the people of Delhi. Close to 4 lakh people are marooned due to floods that have hit Assam, with the surging waters of many rivers inundating fresh areas affecting both people and agricultural land. The National Disaster Response Force, the State Disaster Response Force and Assam Rifles are carrying out rescue operations. Goa's tourism department is set to crack down on errant tourists. It is working on a ban on swimming in the sea from dusk to dawn, limit tourism activity to a limited area on a beach and even put together punitive measures for tourists violating the law. IT giant Tata Consultancy Services has become the first Indian company to close above Rs 7 lakh crore mark in the terms of market capitalization. The shares of the company ended at a fresh lifetime high of Rs 1,841.50 after its board approved a share buyback of up to Rs 16,000 crore. India bowled out Afghanistan 403 in the second innings to win the one-off test by an innings and 262 runs on the second day in Bengaluru on Friday. After India were bowled out for 474 in their first inning, in the morning session, Afghanistan were bundled out for 109 in the first innings of their maiden test. As Salman Khan's Race 3 released on Friday, his good friend Amir Khan wished him luck and said that he loves the actor personally and professionally. Amir took to Twitter to praise the trailer of the Remo D'Souza's directed movie and said he will soon watch the film with his family. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as the news from Punjab and Canada follows.
When you are buying or selling a house or a business, you need proper guidance. We at JP Mellon Law Firm have the knowledge and the expertise to help you close your transaction hassle-free. For all your real estate needs, give us a call. When you are buying or selling a house or a business, you need proper guidance. We at JP Mellon Law Firm have the knowledge and the expertise to to help you close your transaction hassle-free. For all your real estate needs, give us a call.
Welcome back to Indian Times Daily, the top 10 headlines from Punjab are: all national and international flights from the Chandigarh International Airport remain suspended on the second consecutive day because of low visibility due to dust. Rains expected by Saturday will help improve the situation. The alleged murderer of Pakistani Sikh religious leader Charanjit Singh has been arrested. The accused Shahryar Sultan had allegedly killed Singh after he failed to pay extortion money. Singh was killed on May 29 after a lone gunman bagged into his grocery store and shot him dead on the outskirts of Peshawar. Local bodies minister Navjot Singh Sidhu has suspended 8 officials of town planning department for allowing illegal construction in the district. In a surprise raid, Sidhu inspected at least 35 illegal buildings in the district. The union government has countered allegations of poor facilities in prison for 40 Sikh confined in Jodhpur jail. A year earlier, the Amritsar court had directed the centre and state to award a compensation of Rs 4 lakh each to the 46. The Agriculture Department has issued notice to Dera Nanak Sar Tat for transplanting paddy seedling on their land, which is prohibited. Earlier, the state had directed farmers not to sow paddy before June 20th. The plan of the special investigation team to pacify Sikh radical leaders on protest in Bargari has landed in another difficulty. Protesters are demanding that the state prosecute all police officials responsible for killing 2 Sikh protesters at Behbal Kala. District and Sessions Judge Tajvinder Singh, proceeding over the trial of Kathua rape case, has overruled the defence counsel's objection that the English version of the charge sheet has too many mistakes. The judge contended the mistakes were of typographical nature, while the defence claimed that the charge sheet was manipulated. 2 private medical colleges have announced their own hiked fee structure in the state and have denied 50% of their MBBS seats as per government quota. Seat distribution for MBBS course announced by the college are at a variation with the structure notified by the state. The Education Department has announced a new sport policy which makes it mandatory for all students to opt for at least one sports activity in their classes. The policy intends to grade students for which they will be evaluated 3 times in a year. The World Cup spirit has gripped several residents of Hoshiarpur villages as the FIFA World Cup started on Thursday. Football fans are in a tizzy. Various academies, clubs and hotels have made arrangements for game enthusiasts to watch the matches live. I'll be back. Stay logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com as the news from Canada follows.
Scans Accounting.
A team of highly professional accountants, we deliver quality and immeasurable assistance to our clients. For Canada audit assistance and your business loans, the only name you can trust. A professional accountant always makes a difference. For more information, call us at 416-741-0801 or visit us at scansaccountants.com.
Welcome back to IndianTimesDaily.com and the top 10 headlines from Canada are: recent data released by Canada's immigration program shows a sudden spike in Indian immigrants to Canada. This comes as US President Donald Trump dashed the hopes of many applicants for a US green card. Latest figures indicate a staggering increase of 200% plus Indian invitees to Canada this year. The opposition Conservatives have set the stage for a possible overnight voting in the House of Commons in an attempt to get the government to disclose the cost of its carbon tax plans. The Conservatives are vowing to keep Liberal MPs voting for up to 30 straight hours. Senators have passed the Liberal government's budget bill without any amendment, which would see federal carbon pricing plans and small business tax changes become law soon. The bill was approved without a standing vote or discussion at third reading. Ontario's Privacy Commissioner Brian Beamish has sought legislative changes that would give his office oversight of political parties. Beamish pointed out that recent events have revealed how political parties collect and use personal information to target people for political gain, often without people's consent. The Canadian Centre for Child Protection has called for stringent measures after a new report held school employees responsible for hundreds of alleged sexual offences involving students. Researchers found out 750 cases of sexual offences involving at least 1,272 children, which were perpetrated by employees or former employees. The federal government is working towards fulfilling its promise to get rid of fossil fuel subsidies by agreeing to finally explain how much it actually spends on them. As part of both the G7 and G20, Canada has committed to phase out inefficient fossil fuel subsidies. The Supreme Court of Canada has ruled that law societies have the right to deny accreditation to the proposed law school at a Christian university in BC. Trinity Western University requires students to adhere to an agreement allowing sexual intimacy only between a married man and woman. Ottawa area legislator John Fraser has been selected as the new interim leader of the Ontario Liberal Party. Fraser promised to work towards rebuilding the party, which was reduced to 7 members after its stunning defeat in the last week's election. Senators have urged the Trudeau government to improve monitoring of whether Canadian-made military goods are being used to abuse human rights after they are exported to foreign countries. Photos and videos of Saudi forces using Canadian equipment against minority Shia residents in eastern Saudi Arabia had surfaced last year. The Mexican government has taken on Conservative MP Marilyn Gladue for implying that many Mexican visitors to Canada are involved in illegal drug trade. Gladue made the suggestions during debate on the Trudeau government's bill to legalize recreational marijuana. This is the end of the news bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as the news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best Indo-Canadian businesses and resources from accounting firms to wedding planners in your city. All of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.
Welcome to the Field Fresh Supermarket. One-stop shop for fresh vegetables, fruits, bakery products, Indian and Chinese grocery and much more. Visit us today at 5661 Steeles Avenue East in Scarborough, major intersection Steeles and Middlefield. Check out our weekly flyers. Field Fresh Supermarket, always fresh.
Varun Dhawan, Jacqueline Fernandez and Daisy Shah urged people to save the planet by planting more trees and banning plastics. These actors were spreading social awareness on World Environment Day. While Varun attended the beach cleaning drive, Jacqueline and Daisy were seen planting trees in the city. At the event, Varun Dhawan, who sported a casual outfit, will soon begin the promotion of his upcoming film Sui Dhaga Made in India, in which he will be seen paired opposite Anushka Sharma for the very first time. The movie will release in September this year. On the other hand, Jacqueline and Daisy are awaiting for their upcoming action thriller film Race 3, which also stars Salman Khan, Bobby Deol and Anil Kapoor in the lead.
Immigration Terminal, the specialist for visitor visa, student visa, business immigration, family sponsorship, work permits, PNP programs, live-in caregivers and LMIA applications. Highly experienced in cases involving criminal or medical admissibility and previously refused or misrepresentation cases. Call 416-675-5666 in Ontario or 778-927-3455 in BC. Email us at info@immigrationterminal.ca. Immigration Terminal, right consultants, right future.
We are the wedding that features four women, Sonam Kapoor Ahuja, Kareena Kapoor Khan, Swara Bhaskar and Shikha Dhalsania in the leads, released on the 1st of June, and since then, it is doing exceptionally well at the box office. Now, Sonam Kapoor was asked how happy she was to see such a response. She said, "This proves that a male lead is not required for a movie to be a hit," she said.
"It doesn't matter whether it's a man or a woman on the thing, it will, you know, the film will do well, and the obvious bias against women is completely not necessary. I'm very, very happy. I'm very happy for my sister Riya Kapoor, who is a creative producer of the film. I'm happy for Shashank, who directed it. For Kareena, Swara, Shikha, Nika Kapoor, Nikhil, whoever has been part of it. I'm super happy and I'm super excited."
Further, there have been constant speculations on where exactly will Sonam Kapoor settle down now that she is married. Speaking about the same, she said,
"So, but whether I stay in Delhi or Bombay or London, what does it matter? I've decided that I want to be everywhere. Delhi will be home because Delhi's been home for many, many years from now. I am a Delhi Bhabhi, Sasural's Delhi, I guess. And I enjoy being here. So I'm going to be here between Delhi, Bombay and London.
Meanwhile, Veer the Wedding has reached closer to 50 crore mark in just 6 days. Let's wait to find out what will be its lifetime collections.
Karol Bagh Jewelers, ਗਹਿਣਿਆਂ ਦੇ latest design ਲਈ ਪਹਿਲੀ choice. ਸੋਨੇ ਅਤੇ ਹੀਰੇ ਦੇ set, ਚੂੜੀਆਂ ਅਤੇ ਕੜੇ, chain, ਜੜਾਉ set ਅਤੇ ਹੋਰ ਵੀ ਕਈ ਗਹਿਣਿਆਂ ਤੇ special discount. ਸਭ ਤੋਂ ਵੱਡੀ choice, ਬਿਹਤਰੀਨ service ਅਤੇ ਸਭ ਤੋਂ ਵਾਜਿਬ ਰੇਟਾਂ ਲਈ ਆਓ Karol Bagh Jewelers ਅਤੇ Roop Jewelers. Karol Bagh Jewelers, 1098 Peter Robertson Boulevard, Brampton. Roop Jewelers, 503 Ray Lawson Boulevard, Brampton.